I might be selling it today. Taking it to someone who wants to take a look at it. But this is my new bike, the Ninja 650. And I figure, well, I'm not going to have the two of them next to each other for a very long time, or rather own them both at the same time for a very long time. So I want to kind of do a side-by-side so you can kind of get an idea what they look like next to each other. I just kind of give you my reviews of each so far. The Ninja I rode for about 1600 miles, I'd say. It's a great starter bike, very lightweight, very nimble. Like I said, nimble, it's agile. You can really throw it into corners and it just takes them. It's, you know, doesn't really lumber around. It's very light, very easy to manage, manageable power. Really just a great starter bike. And they also hold their value pretty well. Like, I bought this in November for $2,600, and I'm hoping to sell it for about the same. So we'll see what happens with that today. But only complaints about the bike, really, is the same things that makes it good. You know, small engine size and good gas mileage is also what makes it bad, because if you want to do, you know, 55, 60, you got to go all the way up into sixth gear, and you got to work through those gears really quickly, which, you know, gets a little tiring. But at the same time, you can ring this bike out, and it's not going to scare the crap out of you, you know? You know, it'd be a little scary if you'd never ridden before, but that's part of the fun, you know? So let me start it up. This way, if you want to hear side-by-side sound comparison. It's really hot out. Let's see if I can do this without choke. Alright, so you can see it's idling low right now until it warms up. It's sitting right around 1,000, just under 1,000 actually. So we gotta let that warm up. If I was actually gonna ride it, I'd have to choke it. Because I'll show you something that I wish I would have known when I first got the bike, because it scared the crap out of me for a while. If you try to gas it while it's cold, it stalls. Like, what the hell was that? So what you gotta do before you ride it is you always gotta choke it. So turn the choke on. Let it catch up a little bit. And as the bike warms up, you can slowly take the choke off. And now with the choke on, if you rev it, it goes. There's the exhaust side of the bike. If you couldn't tell, I love the blue bikes. Obviously, they're both blue. I will say, there's a few things about the 250 that I think Kawasaki actually did a little bit nicer job with. One being the logo on here. It actually feels like it's a painted on. It's raised up, and it feels like it's got the clear coat going over it. On the 650, on the other hand, you know, the Ninja logo is just a sticker. The same thing with the Kawasaki logo down here. It just kind of feels like it's a sticker that they slapped on. You know, the 650 is meant to be an affordable, you know, mid-range power bike, which it is. You know, it's a very affordable bike for the power you get. Both bikes have dual headlights. Obviously, one is on when you have the low beams on, and if you switch on the high beams, that's your high beam light that's lit up there. And you got both of them on. Have it wink at you. But the 250 is an absolute blast to ride, especially in the twisties. Like, you know, if you're a decent rider on a 250 and you're riding with somebody who just got their 650 and they're not really confident on it, you know, you'll easily be able to keep up and probably even pass it if you wanted to, because it's just such a nimble little machine. You know, it takes corners, it doesn't even, you don't even worry about it. Do one more exhaust test here. Pretty choke down. It's not quite warmed up yet. It's getting there. You see already I can kind of give it some throttle and it's not going to stall on me. So that's the 250. Kill it for now. And then here is my new toy, the 650. Got the same style headlights. Well, as style I mean by dual headlights. Both have the dual headlights. The mirrors are actually very similar on the bikes too. They both got this kind of angled shape. So let's start this guy up. I really like when you start it. It's got this cool startup animation. Pretty sweet. And then the nice thing about it is you got all the different, you know, information that you get from it, which one of the best things it has that the 250 didn't have is a clock. And you cycle through right now, I'm on, that's my average miles per gallon I was getting for the bike. That's range left in the tank, which it doesn't check that until you're moving. Got your odometer, two trip meters, and then your instantaneous miles per gallon. So I'll just leave it on that for now. Nice thing about this one, the seat is a lot thicker, which, let's see if I could even really show you how much your fingers go down into that one. You probably can't be able to tell, but this thumb goes way in. And if I were to do that on the Ninja, you see the amount it goes in is quite a bit less. It's not really as soft. And the rear seat is extremely small on the 250, which is not much bigger. The 600, but it is, you know, somewhat bigger. So if you're riding around with somebody with a big booty, you know, their booty would be more comfortable on this than on that guy. But let's go through a few other things. This is actually, this bike's got hazards, which is kind of nice, you know. Other bike does not. And it also has a passing light, which I don't think it'll do anything when the bike is on. Let me just check. No, the lights aren't on right now. When you turn the bike on, though, it's pretty much like a flasher, is if you want to indicate you're passing somebody, which I know is something that's a lot more used, I think, overseas in the UK, but it's a useful feature. One of the other things that I didn't notice till a couple days ago is it's got these cool little, I guess you'd call them daytime running lights. They look yellow in the video, but they're actually just a white light, and those just stay on. Just, you know, add a little nicety to the bike, which is cool, because, you know, any little extra features like that on a budget bike is a nice plus. You know, they could have easily trimmed those out, but they chose not to. It's got an adjustable clutch lever. I have it right now. I think I have it on the closest setting. I twist it. Looks like it's moving out a little further with each click. Yeah, that's much further away. And if you want to bring it back, it's easier just to push that out and slide it back. Yes, that's the farthest out. That's the closest. Same with the front brake. Your kill switch right here. Horn. Oh, I pissed off someone's dog. Let's start it up. It's got a... Oh, shit.